Hello guys, and welcome to How to Tech. Today's video we'll try to create some consistent characters in Midjourney using version 4, and we will also try to find out different methods in which we can create the characters more consistently. So make sure that you watch the video till the end. So let's go to Discord and get started. So I'm in Discord. I'll just go ahead and write the imagine prompt. So I'll be giving the prompt as stunning woman with long hair, wavy blonde hair, bright blue eyes, wearing leather jacket and pants, realistic webtoon style. And make sure that you also name the character. So my character name would be Anna. And I'll write Anna as stunning woman with long hair. Let's see what Midjourney comes up with. So these are the four images that are generated by Midjourney. So to make the characters consistent, we will go ahead and try to upscale one of the images, or probably the third one, because the face is much more visible. But let us go ahead and try to upscale the third one. So guys, we have upscaled the third version over here. So once the upscaling is done, we have to tell Midjourney that this is a good image. So for doing that, you have to press this happy icon over here. And by pressing this, I'm telling Midjourney that this is a good image. Please render images based on this particular portrait. And apart from that, I also need the seed number for this particular image. How you'll get the seed number is, it's very easy. You have to come to this particular add reactions on the right hand side top, and there is an envelope symbol. You have to click on this envelope. Once you click on the envelope, what Midjourney will do, it will automatically give you the seed number for this particular image. So look, this is going to be the seed number for the image. So let me just copy this particular prompt over here, and I'll be pasting the seed number as well. So this is going to be the seed number. Okay, so I will, this is the seed number. So let me go back to my server, and I will just type in /imagine. Correct, and I will paste the entire prompt over here. Right, the same prompt. Anna is a stunning woman with long hair, wavy blonde hair, bright blue eyes, wearing leather jacket and pants, realistic webtoon style. And after that, I'll be giving hyphen hyphen seed, and I'll be pasting the seed number from the image that I just copied. So this is going to be the seed number. So by giving the seed number, I'm telling Midjourney that create an image similar to this particular image. Okay, great. So Midjourney has again given me four images, out of which I really like the fourth one, this particular image. So I'll go ahead and upscale the fourth image. Great. So guys, Midjourney has given me this particular image now, and I have to tell Midjourney that you have done a good job. So I'll just go ahead and click on the happy icon again. And similarly, for the second time also, I'll go to add reactions, and I will click on this envelope to get the seed number. Right, automatically I'll get this notification in Midjourney. I'll click over here, which gives me the seed number for this particular image. So I'll copy the seed number, I'll go to my notepad, I'll paste the second seed number over here, and again I'll copy the original prompt. I'll return to Midjourney, my server. Again, similarly, I'll type in imagine, paste the prompt, again give hyphen hyphen seed, and this time I'll give the second seed number, this particular one, and I'll click on enter. So again, Midjourney will be giving me four different images, from which I'll be upscaling one image which is more closer to the image that I want, and I'll be again extracting the seed, and I'll be repeating the entire process at least 6 to 7 times. So for the sake of everyone's convenience, we will just do a quick editing, and we will straightforward go to the 6th or the 7th iteration image, and let us see how it looks like. So guys, finally our character is done. We have had almost 6 iterations to this particular character. Now what we will do is, we will again give it a happy rating from AI, and we'll take the seed of this particular image. So this is going to be the seed number, and we will use this seed number going forward. So this is going to be my base image. Okay, Okay, so the seed number is going to be very important. So now I will try to place this particular character in different scenes, right? So I'll say slash imagine, and I will paste the prompt of Anna, and then I'll just say after webtoon style, I'll say on a beach. So the background I'm expecting is should be on a beach, and then followed by hyphen hyphen seed and giving the seed number. So let's wait and watch what Midjourney gives the output. Yeah, so these particular characters, if you see the facial expressions and everything, it matches with my main character, which is this. Okay, the main character, the facial expression and the blonde hair, everything will be matching with the main character over here. And now let us put this character to test. Let us try to give different expressions altogether, right? Slash imagine. So I will just paste everything along with the seed number, but instead of on a beach, I will write smiling. Okay, so I'll try to create a smiling character just by giving the prompt of smiling, but the seed number should be same. So let us see what Midjourney generates. Well, although I have specified as smiling, but I see only I think two characters which are smiling. So I'll go ahead and probably increase the weightage of this particular verb. I will tell happy smiling, and to increase the weightage of smiling, I'll say 1.5. Let's see what happens. Now, after putting in the weightage, we are seeing that the character is actually smiling. For all the four characters are actually smiling. Okay, so accordingly, you need to put in the emotions as well. So let me go ahead and put in one more emotion. I want this particular character to shout and scream. So just as an experiment to see what happens. So I will now give the verb as shouting and increase the weightage to 1.5. You see, these are the four shouting images that I'm having, and it's almost preserved. You know, obviously a bit of distortion will be there, but I think this particular character is the nearest one for the shouting image. So I can go ahead and probably upscale this particular character. Now, a special trick out of the hat I want to give you is, you can just add a particular prompt at the end, something like six panels with different dynamic poses. I'll say slash imagine, I'll paste the entire thing, and over here, I'll just write six panels with different dynamic poses. Okay, great. Let me go ahead and see it in the browser. We are getting some two panels and three panels, not six panels, but this is the gist of the thing. So the same character, look and feel wise, it will be the same, but with different expression, facial expressions and poses altogether, which you can go ahead and use these characters maybe in creating webtoons and comic books and whatnot. So this is a very important trick that I generally use. Okay, then again I'll go to slash imagine, and this time let me go ahead and change the six to maybe four panels, right? The last experimentation, probably give a four panel with different dynamic poses and emotions. So I have added in emotions as well, the same prompt along with the same seed number. I'll just key in enter. Okay, so this is going to be the final version, guys. So I think this particular picture is stunning. It looks more close to the original picture as well, which I took. One more important thing, we hope that with the release of the version 5 of Midjourney, things would be far more easier, because it was not too good with V3. Midjourney had made a lot of progress in V4, and we are rooting for the Midjourney V5 prompts. I hope that you know, even you do not have to do these things which I am doing once V5 will be available. So fingers crossed for V5. Till then, if you're liking my videos, guys, I request you to go ahead and subscribe to the channel. If you have any comments related to the consistency of the characters in Midjourney in version 3 or in version 4, do let me know through your comments. And that's it. Till the next time we meet, keep creating and happy AI. Bye-bye.